please welcome Mohit Goel with Project Motion Map.
Ooh!
You're looking sharp.
Hi, Mohit.
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Jessica.
Good luck. I like your striped shirt.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
You look great.
All right, wreck this. Wreck it.
Sure.
This is what I'm gonna hype everybody so far up. They're gonna wish.
Okay.
You're gonna be amazing. Let's do it, King.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Okay. Dive in. Okay. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
I'm super excited to show you Project Motion Map, an interesting way to turn your design ideas to life. So I'm an illustrator web with the logo of a meal delivery service that I'm working on. So I would love to add some motion to it, but I don't want to wrestle with timelines or keyframes. You know the drill, right? So no worries. Project Motion Maps comes to our rescue. We can specify what we want to motion map, and it does the trick. So let me add a couple of prompts. Let me just make the eyes blink.
Oh, so I can see it. Okay.
There we go.
I can see it here. We're looking, I'm not ignoring it.
And also a prompt to rotate the text. And let's see what Project Motion Map does. Wow, our logo is now winking, rotating.
What in the hell are you guys clapping at? What just happened? Walk me back like I'm a shark, okay? And I'm Mark Cuban.
Yeah.
What did I just see?
He typed in blink for the eyes.
No, he did not.
It recognized that they were eyes.
Stop it.
And I'm not sure the second prompt, something about rotate in or something.
Yeah,
like
rotate in the text. So logo is now winking, blinking.
I see. That's awesome. Okay. Wow.
Pretty cool.
Okay, let's move to the next asset.
Okay.
Which is a juicy burger, basically sitting on top of some text.
Okay.
So you guys might be wondering what is happening behind the scenes when Motion Map is doing its tricks, right? So let me try to share the secret sauce here. I'm opening the Motion Map agent. I will try to animate the burger with the stacking effect and text fade in. So stay with me on this window. It is going to reveal a lot of tricks. So I just hit the animate button. So Motion Map is analyzing my artwork layer by layer. It will analyze the semantics. It will also generate the animation concept. It will assign that to each layer. And it will even write the animation code line by line.
Wow.
So we can see that on the screen in a couple of seconds. So I call it vibe animation, guys, and I can't love it enough. So based on this, it will generate multiple variations, one of which will be displayed on the screen. Wow. This is really mouth-watering.
Wow. Cool.
So this is Motion Map doing the heavy lifting for our taste buds.
That is so cool.
So our burger is now ready. Maybe we want to deliver it faster. So let's move to our next asset. So we really don't want to tell Motion Map every time what we want to do. Instead, it can analyze the artwork, and it can figure out automatically how we want to animate. So let me hit the auto animate button, and let's see the magic again. So it has made the scooter move.
Wow.
One click.
So let me just ask that. I want to be clear why I'm clapping. So it looked at that and then was like, this is how you want it animated? Did it infer that? Is that what you were saying?
Yeah, this is auto animating that stuff.
That's amazing.
I have not provided anything.
Wow.
Yeah. Recognize that as a scooter.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's a thing.
And it's free delivery. That's going to be a yeah from this shark.
Just that I want to be a bit more playful, or should I say a bit more greedy. I want my design elements to be aware of each other's motion. So let's try that. I want eyes to follow the scooter, and maybe cool. Scooter to glide back delivery style. So let's see how does that work.
Wow. That's crazy. This is amazing.
Yeah, and it's dynamically following.
Yeah, that's insane.
So our eyes are already alive. They are tracking the movement. And this is eye rolling, literally and visually.
Wow. This is like watching a magic show in Vegas to me right now.
Okay, so we have one more flavor of motion map where it can analyze our artwork, it can determine how it is built, and it can basically show the on-canvas suggestions using the illustrator's very own technology. So let me show you what I mean when I say all of that. So I just put the inspiration button, and you can see that it has determined that swing is the correct motion for the girl, and it is using Illustrator's very own puppet warp tool for the same. Cool. We can see the puppet warp mesh on the girl and the tree, and also the control points. These control points are interactive. We can play around with this. We can modify them while keeping the essence of the original smart suggestions alive. I can select some of the suggestions and hit the animate button, and let's see what it does. So it has analyzed the artwork, and it makes the girl swing.
Wow. Crazy. The kids will never know we used to blow into cartridges to get the Nintendo 64 to start.
Why did we do that? I
am old. Wow.
Okay, I think enough of work. Time for some fun. So I think, before I begin, I just want to let you know that motion map is able to determine that this is a game of chess. These are the chess pieces along with the shadows, and it even has to craft a game of chess with whatever I say. So maybe, Jessica, I could use your help.
Okay.
You want a quick game of chess?
I don't know how to play. I play checkers.
Okay, maybe we can quickly finish it.
But I saw, Harry Potter, like the end of the first one, it's like I could do... I could figure it out.
Okay, yeah. So maybe we can have a quick game of chess. We can quickly finish it.
Okay.
So let's say, give me the number of moves you want to finish it in. Give me a number between 2 to 5.
2
Four.
To 5.
4.
4. 4. Okay. Good enough.
We're supposed to be on the same page and stuff like that.
Let me finish this game in 4 moves.
Okay.
And let's see what it brings up. Oops. No worries. We can always try it again.
If you know how to play chess. Okay. Raise your hand if you don't know how to play chess is better.
Okay, so it has crafted a game of chess.
It
has made
the... Checkmate.
Okay. Wow.
She won, Jessica.
Yeah, that was insane. Wait, so you did it in like 4 moves?
I think you did it in like 2. But the idea is it's based on logic and will animate based on logic.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it has basically understood the logic. It realized that it has to merge the layers for chess pieces and the shadows, and that it understood the logic as well.
Wow. Can I ask you, how long have you been working on this?
Sorry?
How long have you been working on this?
Couple of months.
Couple of months?
Stop it.
Bro, I feel scared of you. I'm scared of this man.
Mohit, you are the man.
This guy is like a super genius. I thought he was going to be like 10 years. Like, my wife and kids don't see me at all. Like, I haven't been home. This dude said too much.
Yeah. You're amazing, man.
Okay.
You are. What else you got? You got something else?
Okay.
No, like,
I'm done. That's Project Motion Map that is driven by semantics, guided by prompts, and defined by you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mohit.
Great job.
Awesome.
Welcome.
Well played. Super cool. I feel really lazy.
I am so scared of him, and I feel like I'm going to be afraid of every genius developer that comes out here.